6:30 p.m. 67 minutes later, you're going to dock at the Russian space station to meet cosmonaut Andropov, who will refuel the shuttles with liquid O2. That's your fuel.
The last
then you'll release and take a 60-hour trip toward the moon. Now, we only have one shot of landing on this rock, and that's precisely when the asteroid passes by the moon. You'll then use lunar gravity and burn your thrusters, slingshotting you around the moon, coming up behind the asteroid. You'll be upward of 11
feet. Yeah, I remember this one. It's where the coyote sat in the asteroid on a slingshot, and he strapped himself to an Acme rocket.
So, all the people's names. Are you glad I remembered all their names? So the names are...
We have a lot better rockets than the coyote. Now, when you finish your Roadrunner thrust move, you'll be moving at 22,500 miles per
hour. Look,
coming around behind the asteroid, where we're hoping that the tail debris will be cleared by the moon's gravity. And you'll land right here. That's it.
We've got separate landing sites for each team. Softest parts of the rock are bigger. At NASA, we don't take chances. We double up on everything. First team that hits 800 feet. Now this rock is big, it's dense, it's got some gravity. You can walk around. But use your thrusters so you can work easily.
Okay, Mr. Truman, let's say that we actually do land on this. What's it going to be like up there?
200 degrees in sunlight, minus 200 in the shade, canyons of razor-sharp rock, unpredictable gravitational conditions, unexpected eruptions, things like that.
Okay, so the scariest environment imaginable. Thanks. That's all you got to say, scariest environment.
What am I going to do?
Okay, so you drill, you drop the nuke, and you leave.
Is that funny, Mom?
You're going to remote detonate the bomb. Now, if the bomb explodes after zero barrier,
that's everyone in my class. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.